Hi, 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 hello friends. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Now, in this session, we'll continue our previous SSC JEE 2013 Electrical Solutions Part 9. The question is, in a motor starter, the electromechanical contactor, so electromechanical contactor provides inherent protection against. So as you can see here, it's a 4-point starter, and this is the electromechanical contactor, and here we have holding coil. So whenever the voltage below the rated voltage, so voltage is less than V rated voltage, then this holding coil releases this spindle or moving contact. So when you want to start the 3 points, DC motor, so we will move this studs like this. Okay, so at this point, whenever the low voltage condition or power failure condition, the holding coil releases this soft iron piece, okay, or starter handle, it will revert back like this. So the answer is under voltage or low voltage condition. The next question is, in a circuit, V is the input voltage applied across the capacitor 2F. Current through the capacitor is, so general formula is IC is equal to C into dV by dt. So we need to find the slope of voltage. What is the dV by dt here during this period? First period, it is 1, 10 by 1. So IC is equal to C is 2 into dV by dt, means difference is 10 divided by 1. So how much you got? 20 amps, the first case. Next case, from here to here. So it is how much? So IC is equal to, what's the slope here? The slope here is, so M is equal to Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. So Y2 minus Y1 here is, so minus 12 minus 10 divided by 3 minus 1 is nothing but minus 11. So minus 11 into the time period here is, so into the capacitance is 2, this is equal to minus 22 amps. So from the given options, D is a correct option. The next question is, in a semiconductor, resistivity depends upon. So the given thing is resistivity rho, but not R. So resistivity depends upon temperature. If they ask for resistance, means depends upon voltage, depends upon current through it. So resistivity is a depends upon only on its temperature, not on voltage and current through it. It depends upon property of material. The next question is, a geyser is operated from 230 volts, 50 cycles per second. So 50 cycles per second means 50 frequency is 50 hertz. The frequency of instantaneous power consumed by geyser is, so P of T is always having a frequency of 2 times the supply frequency, as we seen in our previous SSC solutions. So 2 into 50 cycles per second is nothing but 100 cycles per second. The answer is C here. Next question here is, the ampere second is a unit of. So the current is proportional to dq by dt. So I into dt is nothing but dq. So you can write I into t as q. That is, ampere second is nothing but a unit of charge. Electric charge. Thank you, friends. Thanks for watching my video. We'll continue next session.